I hope you get the analogy of our little demonstration here. Because if you can see these tomato plants, if you can see them in the bottom of the camera, to me, if I was looking at the video, this video, I would say those are weeds. And in your life as a Christian, there are weeds growing up right now. Because there is this popular concept that's been brainwashed into Americans for some reason about somehow, right or wrong, we're supporting Israel no matter what. Even if Israel itself is the problem. Even if Israel itself is apostate from God. Even if Israel itself turns its back on God, no matter what, the Christian says, I'm going to support Israel. And that's the way they act. And that's the way they talk. And that's the way they walk. And that's the way it's being presented. Whether it be, you know, Christians United for Israel or any other Christian group, there is this habit of taking the Word of God and making it not fit the Scriptures. In other words, what they're doing is they're trying to make you support patriotically this nation that God has said, look, I will not come to you again until you say, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. We as Christians are called to pray for the peace of Jerusalem, not pray for the nation of Israel. We are called to bless the nation of Israel, but not to absorb and to accept all of its actions as though it were from God himself. No, we have 6 million Jews in America today, right now. You can count them. They've been counted. The Brandeis University keeps track. There's barely over 6 million in Israel. And most of those Jews that are in Israel don't serve God. They don't at all. Most of them do not believe in God. As a matter of fact, most of them accept the Bible as being a philosophical book. I know. I live there. I talk to the Israeli. The Sabra that is born there is a Zionist. And a Zionist is what you would call a socialist. They are liberal, you would say, Democrats, if you wanted to call it that, even though it's really socialism, so they're more like communists than anything else. So where do you get this whole idea about somehow as a Christian, you're supposed to support Israel because it's got enemies? What if God raised up Egypt and said, I'm using Egypt to challenge Israel till it repent? Are you going to stand in front of Egypt and say, I'm sorry, but you know what? I understand that God's using you in order to drive Israel to their knees, but I'm going to go against God and I'm going to go against you because I'm going to stand in the way because, after all, I made a treaty with Israel. Ha ha, yeah, me and the Antichrist and Israel together, we're all made a treaty. You know, we're going to stand with them right or wrong. No! Get a grip, Christian. You're being duped. You're being deceived. You're letting your emotions take over your devotion. You see, you're devoted to God. What you want for the Jew is salvation. You don't want Israel just to be a nation, because an apostate nation is what killed Jesus in the first place. A nation that had turned its back on God, that said, better that one man die than the whole nation be destroyed. And so God said, you want to bet? And he destroyed the nation, dispersed them throughout the world, because they chose Israel at the time of Jesus chose that one man die, then the whole nation to be destroyed. And then they even went out and picked their own Messiah, even as they're going to do it again. They picked their own Messiah to replace who we as Gentiles, I'm not a Gentile, I'm a Jew, but anyways, who we in our own knowledge and wisdom have determined that we know now that this was Jesus the Messiah that had come, the suffering servant. But at that time they chose a different Messiah to revolt against Rome. And it caused the destruction of the temple. It caused the destruction of Jerusalem, and it caused the entire nation to be annihilated, to be dispersed, even as God said it would be, and Jesus prophesied that it would happen. So where do you get a scripture that says, oh, I pledge allegiance to Israel? You don't. You see, you're being lied to. You're letting your emotion, again, cloud your devotion. Because your devotion is supposed to be to witness to the Jew first, then to the Gentile. You are called to speak to the Jew and tell them they are in sin, just like every other person in the course of humanity and mankind, as they have gone off on a tangent, gone their own way, chosen to be sinners, because that is what Israel is today. It's a sinner. It's a sinful nation. It's turned its back on God. It is not walking with God. It has not chosen to be with God. you can talk to an Orthodox Jew and you'll find out, no, God is the farthest thing from what they're really serving. They're serving the Torah. They're serving the law. They're serving a religious system. If you wanted to make it so adamant and so realistic, then you would say that they are the worst of Catholics, because some people think that Catholics don't serve God. They are the worst of religions because they turn their back on God, and they are allowing rabbis to make determinations for the Word of God that God never said they could do. They are not to change the Word of God, and yet they have. Even in the very nature of the miracles, they have claimed false miracles to the people of Israel. They have said to the world, oh, well, Hanukkah, you know, we had only so much oil and it was a miracle. It became more. No, it didn't. It's a lie. It was proven a lie. It was something that was used by the priesthood in order to unify the people. Oh, we need to bring them all together. Kind of like what they're doing to you now. Kind of like what you're doing to yourself. Kind of like what you see all these religious leaders who say, oh, you know what? We don't want a witness to Israel. We don't want the Jews to get saved. They have some blindness, you know. Never mind what Jews for Jesus says. Never mind what Hebrews for Christians says. Never mind that, you know, there's always been some witness, you know, like Christians for Israel, or there's been, Chosen People ministries that have been gone on from the 1800s when a rabbi got saved, an Orthodox rabbi got saved and started an organization to witness to the Jew. Guess what? God has been working on Jews all along, and Jews are getting saved. I know. I was part of the Hebrew Jewish Fellowship in Calvary, Costa Mesa. Don't give me the whole rigmarole of telling me that we have to support Israel. No, you don't. You don't support ungodliness. You don't support sin. You don't pay for the annihilation of some other people groups. You pay for the gospel to go forth unto the Jew first and to the Gentile, even as we at the Calvary Chapel Movement and the Jesus Movement have done. Jews for Jesus goes out and has an active participation and role in Israel today. Calvary Chapels are established in Jerusalem. I know. I was there. I helped participate. I was a church secretary for a while. Even there, you see how Jews get saved by Jesus reaching into the life of a Jew and touching them the same way that you were touched, the same way that you were called, the same way that you were chosen. You see, it's not about supporting a nation that's turned its back on God. It's supporting the people who have turned their hearts to Jesus and learning to live the Lord thy God in their heart, soul, and mind, and strength, so they would be a witness to the nation, and they would live there and be a light shining in the darkness. You're standing in God's way. What are you doing, Christian? Why are you compromising? Why have you let these roots, these weeds, come up in your theology, and you believe in Christian Zionism? To deny the gospel to the Jew? Excuse me. And as much as you've done it to the least of my brethren, you've done it unto Jesus. You deny God to the Jew, then you are denied by Jesus himself. Look at it. You're risking your salvation. That's what you're doing. You have weeds in your theology, and you have made a mistake. You have gone the heir of Balaam, who sold out his birthright in order to follow Balak into sin and idolatry. Get real. Get to the Word of God. Understand it. This religiosity has gotten to be too far. You have gone too far. You've gotten too extreme. You've gotten to the place where even God is disgusted with what's being done in the name of, quote-unquote, blessing Israel. You're not. You're leading it right to the doorstep of the Antichrist himself, and the false Messiah will stand on your back and say, thank you for giving me Israel. Thank you for making this treaty with me. Thank you for giving me the nation, because you've helped me to do what I was planning to do all along, with or without you. So yeah, you go ahead and tell me how you support the nation. You go ahead and tell me how you're doing it. Tell me exactly what kind of gospel you're sharing with the Jew, with the people that died, with the people that lived at the time that Jesus rose from the dead, and that set forth the boundaries and the foundation stones that became Christianity, that later became Catholicism, that later became Protestant, that later became the denominations, that later became evangelicals, that became you. What are you doing for the Jew today? How dare you? How dare you deny my God to my people? How dare you say that you support Israel and you won't witness to them? And you take the monies and the support and you give it to organizations that do not share the gospel because they've signed a treaty not to with Israel itself. Tell me what kind of Christian that is. You deny me before man, I'll deny you before the Father. You need to repent. Because that's what you've done. You have put a stumbling block before the people of Israel. You are not blessing them. If you blessed them, you would give them Jesus. If you were blessing them, you'd give them God. If you were blessing them, you would share the good news. But what you're doing is you're putting a stumbling block. You've let weeds distract you from the attraction of what Messiah is to a Jew. You've taken away the one gospel that can save a man from hell itself, because the Jew that dies today goes to hell. And what are you doing? Condemning a whole nation to hell by your support of Israel? You need to repent. You need to repent. Can I say it one more time? You need to repent. You're wrong. Because in religiosity, you've taken the religion of man and you've adapted it to political reform, and you've suddenly become, we're going to support the democratic Israel. Right. The Zionist Israel, which is a Zionist country, which has admitted to itself, it is Zionist. It's fine with it. Has no problem with it. Americans have a problem with not being Americanized, but guess what? That's what Jewish is. It's Zionistic. It has always been. It came from Russia at one point in time when they decided to make a Jewish nation after Zionism. And Zionism is not American democracy. I'm sorry. It's not. As a matter of fact, even the great hero of the faith, supposedly, Benjamin Netanyahu, who is not a Christian, has said, look, we don't have democracy like you have. We have, really, in a way, truer democracy. Not really, they have Zionism. But the point is that they have their own version of what we say is, oh, the democratic nation, because they vote. Excuse me? Excuse me? Go live in the nation for a while, and then talk to me about what you're doing and what you're helping and how you're serving God by somehow taking these Christian Zionist organizations and accepting what they're feeding you as far as selling out your soul and your gospel for the sake of, oh, we supported Israel because we wanted to be blessed. And as much as we've blessed Israel, we'll be blessed. No, because in as much as you've done it to the least of my brethren, you've done it unto Jesus. So you take your blessing of Israel and you stack it right next to what you've done to the Son of God. And I'll show you where we're going, because that's what the reality is. Israel will never repent until they say, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. And that's your message to Israel today. That's what you should be sharing. Jesus will come and they will repent. And they will mourn as for an only son once they realize what they have done, and all the millions of Jews that have died because they could have been saved if we had done our part to share Jesus to a nation that should be repenting even now.